My name is Ivan Neville, born and raised in New Orleans, Louisiana, son of Aaron Neville and Joelle Rue Neville, nephew to Art Neville, Charles Neville, and Cyril Neville. It's pretty cool. You know what? I didn't know what to expect. I was kind of, you know, I'm usually like when they decide to have another musical gathering as such as this, I'm usually kind of at first saying, okay, you know, I mean, it's obviously any excuse there is for people from where we come from here, to get together and party and play music and listen to music and eat food. We don't need it. We will do that. We will do that. So my first thoughts were, okay, we're having another little festival. Let's see. But it's pretty cool. It's like way cool. And then I know that it's affiliated with the Jazz Museum and all that stuff and what that entails. I mean, obviously, to direct, to point, shine a light on what this place is about, and trying to just, you know, keep alive the strong presence of what New Orleans is mostly about, this music and this culture that we fortunate enough to be a part of. And so I'm cool. I had fun playing too. I was like, wow, until, you know, some stuff kind of happened that wasn't to my liking, but I mean, stuff like that happens. But the energy was amazing. The people were cool. I dig it so far. So I look forward to them doing it again. I mean, this is our life. This is our like lifeline. You know, I mean, we breathe. We need food and we need oxygen. We need this music thing here. And obviously the combinations of stylings of music that we do, it's like just combines many different elements, you know. It's just pretty much like the signature dish, which is gumbo. Just add a bunch of stuff together and it all comes out pretty soulful, I mean, to say the least. When I was about 6 years old, there was a drum kit set up in our living room. We were living on Chestnut Street, 4828 Chestnut Street. And it was Zigaboo's drum kit set up in our living room. I don't know why it was there. And at one point, I remember one day we all took turns, my mom included, playing the drum beat to Big Chief. They would put the record on and you would sit behind the drum kit and see if you can catch that beat. And all of us did a pretty good job on it. So that was kind of the first time I actually did anything of that nature. But I later on played guitar a little bit when I was about 10 or 11 years old. And, you know, I was interested in sports and stuff like that. But when I was 15, I sat down at the piano and started figuring out that that's what I really dug. And that's what I started doing. And that was it. I just learned by ear and, you know, my dad taught me some songs and I was always around all the music and stuff. And James Booker was a friend of the family's. He'd come by the house, I'd see him play. My uncle Art Neville, obviously. So it was around and it was kind of, I guess it was in the blood. And I just kind of picked it up and, you know, mostly learned by ear and by feel, you know. About Fats Domino and him? Oh no, that was like the start of like rock and roll. I mean, those guys were pioneers. It went totally beyond New Orleans. And they made, I mean, everything that rock and roll became was, those guys were part of the foundation of that stuff. And then, I mean, and then obviously right after Fats, all of those records that they recorded down here, the Little Richard stuff, the Larry Williams stuff that was recorded at Cosmo Studios, that's all the stuff that influenced some of the most, like the Beatles and the Rolling Stones, who are still out there doing it. Them dudes are 80 years old and they still making music, and they were all influenced by that stuff. Fats Domino, he's like one of the pioneers. Well, you kind of, you know what, when you, just you mentioning that, it kind of pisses me off, because music, when we were coming up, there was a lot of music in schools. And it seems like there's all this money allotted to do all kinds of stuff. But where it's really important, teachers make shit money. And that's the most important job that there is. And let alone music. There was instruments, stuff like that. There was funding somewhere that came, that there was music in schools. And that shit's rare nowadays. So it's like, it makes me angry that the kids coming up now, there's, the technology has grown the way it's grown, so you got access to a lot of stuff that we didn't have access to, but it was more, it was naturally afforded to us. And by being in schools and by them having music classes, music is like, it's like love. It's like, that's two one in the same. Music and love, it's the same thing. I'm fortunate, blessed, and absolutely, I'm grateful that I get to do that. I mean, that's what comes to mind initially. I mean, I feel like so much gratitude, for being able to play music, and my whole life been playing it, and that's my job. I'm absolutely fortunate. Explore. You might want to know a little bit about some business. Be good at math. No, and then you want to learn about music publishing and stuff like that. Look into all of that. Everything that I play is based on all the stuff that I was inspired by. Like, I was influenced by obviously the local, my family and the meters and all that stuff. But I grew up in a glorious time for music. In the early 70s, the radio was on and there was this music that was just so diverse. And people were making records in a different way back then, and it was not formulated and specific, like making music to sound a certain way. People were just figuring out that they wanted to play music, and they were just making music. And that's why you had all kinds of different genres, and I remember you could listen to music on the radio, and you could hear something. I remember hearing two songs back to back on one radio station. And the two songs was Benny and the Jets and Tell Me Something Good by Rufus and Chaka Khan. Those songs sound totally opposite, not opposite, but they sound totally different. But I loved both of those songs. And that kind of being inspired by all of those different, genres or what you might want to call it, it has really helped me develop kind of how I want to express music. So yeah, thank you, Ronnie. Thank you. Appreciate it. All right.